There's a rumor going around that Christians don't know how to have fun. Yeah, I can't believe it myself. It's kind of crazy. Let's prove them wrong, right? We have a very special show in store for you tonight. Very, very special. And I do hope you enjoy it. We've transplanted a southern institution to the north. And we're not sure if it's going to take. It's a very, very serious grafting operation. So let's see what happens. Hope you enjoy it. Let's bring them up. Domingo, Domingo doing a Patsy Cline tune called Crazy. Oh man.
Yeah.
I was at church on a Sunday and Steve Kinnard came up to me and he said, "Brother, for the singles night, we're gonna do a grand ol' Opry hour." I said, "What?" He said, "We're gonna do a grand ol' Opry hour." I said, "Oh, yeah, Steve. Me and my family used to sit in front of the radio every Saturday night in Brooklyn and listen to the grand ol' Opry. What a great idea." I said, "Well, I don't know what the grand ol' Opry is. I didn't listen to that sort of stuff. I didn't think anybody listened to that sort of stuff." I led a very sheltered existence. So they bought me a book. I'm learning everything I can about the Grand Ole Opry. I wanna bring out three young ladies. We call them our sisters of sweetness because when they sing, it's like sugar. Let's bring out Teresa, Jane, and Kimberly. Time to time.
in Tahoe.
Bring a few people in.
And today we have a dear friend of mine who we go way back. We performed together a long time ago, and this touches my heart to have him here with us on this special night. I'd like to bring out, and I would like you all to give a warm Opry welcome to Mr. Sammy Davis Jr. That's right.
If you notice, I'm not doing a jewelry bit today. I do have this because this is very special to me. This was Roy Clark doing this to me. The man that I actually
played. You look beautiful anyway, Sammy.
Well, thank you.
You don't need that. You don't need those ornaments.
I'm feeling great. At least class is swinging. Take care of this bitch, you know, because we have two kids coming out, and they are hot, man. They will rock this place. They're doing John Denver Medley, is it correct?
Yeah.
I knew that you would dig it. So Robert and Joe, if you get prepared, babes, we'll wrap this up. I have to get out of here because I have an optometrist appointment. I'm sorry, but, you know. So, Brenda and Joe, swing the place.
Almost heaven.
Bow down when you are.
boy. Yeah, I got me a pound up, I got me over the limits. I'm coming up, I think I'm gonna do it. And I bring you nothing but a funny money rhythm. Here in New York City at the Grand Ole Opry, Miss Millian Davison. Bring her out here. First time on the Opry. That's
me. You told me you were through with me.
We have several sponsors of our show tonight, and Jimmy Dean's Pure Pork Sausage. And we have Jimmy Dean's has kindly offered to sponsor a contest. Jimmy Dean's doesn't know it yet, but they're sponsoring a contest. Contest is this. We have contestants picked out from our audience, and I would like several people to come up on stage if they would. Serena, can I have you come up here, please? Serena? Let's bring up Serena. Oh, yeah. And Mr. Harper Grayson and Mr. Harper Grayson, you come up on stage. Devon, can I get Devon up here, please? Thanks a lot, Devon. Come on up. Come on up. At Jimmy Dean's, what we wanted to find out was who amongst our willing contestants has the most authentic Southern accent. You, our studio audience, will be the judge. So if I could have our contestants at one of these three mics, please. What we'll have them say, they'll all have to say the same thing. I will hold my hand over their head and our applause meter will register behind me. Okay? What they'll be saying is this. Howdy and welcome to New York City. We're so glad you could come. All right? Can you repeat that after me, please? Howdy and welcome to New York City. We're so glad you could come. First contestant, Serena. Loser.
Isn't he great?
I wanna just let him know what his prize is. Kevin, you have won a year's supply of Jimmy Dean's Pure Pork Sausage.
All right.
Breakfast, you want to go out and pick up some of your packages of Jimmy Dean sausage. It may be fresh right out there in the grinder's fridge from the fattest hogs we got. That's Jimmy Dean sausage, folks. All the stars of Grand Ole Opry every day. Thank you.
Just change the mood a little bit.
Yeah.
I know it's too exciting for you. We have Ms. Mary Ann Barron coming up to sing for you, I Fall to Pieces.
Let me take you to the
I the next portion of our grand old opera is brought to you by Martha Whiteflower. This portion is proudly brought to you by Martha Whiteflower because you can make them buttermilk biscuits, them buttermilk pancakes, and get a homemade butter roll. Just go out to your local store and pick up 5 pounds of flair. Martha Whiteflower, that is all the stars on the Grand Ole Opry. Break with Martha Whiteflower. Just ask Miss Aunt Minnie Pearl about it, okay? Minnie Pearl, as she bakes with Martha Whiteflower. I didn't introduce her to sing the next song, did I?
There you have it.
The song needs no introduction. He doesn't have one prepared. spectrum. Remember before I told you we have a lot of special guests, and I meant it. We have a lot of special guests. We have one who can just be here for a few minutes with us. This is a guy, he's a New York City boy, thus he's close to my heart, being a New York City boy myself. We grew up on the streets together, and he grew up kind of hard. He had a tough life. It's hard. We don't have grass in the city. So when you fall, you get hurt. You don't have like knolls and farmland and horses. Yeah, knolls. I said knolls. You know, these things I call knolls. And they have them in the summer, and they don't have them in New York. And this guy was very small. He's kind of the runt of his family. Yeah, and he got beat up a little bit. I personally didn't beat him up, all right? I wasn't one of those guys who beat him up. I never got beat up because I ran fast. But we used to run in the same circles. I want you all to give a warm New York welcome to Mr. Woody Allen. I could just... bring the jet concept with this joke. It comes to my understanding that due to research that I've done on the subject, extensive research, it would be proper at this point for me to greet you all in a fashion similar to this yee-haw. I just wanted to say that, you know, I wasn't exactly sure why they would have, you know, someone like me at a function like this. Because, you know, I'm basically, you know, I'm not countrified, and the total Manhattanite, you know, the south for me is Brooklyn, so. And, you know, and me personally, I'm the south, and it's, you know, I don't need to be didactic or facetious in any manner, and I say this, but the South community has no redeeming social background. Don't be a hostile because, you know, I break out the rash. But I mean, you have the basic grit, you know, and there's no sidewalks, no place to walk after dinner, and there's woods and swamps, you know, weird things crawling around that you don't see in the city, you know, like body of a crab and a head of a social worker. And you know, you got the basic gingham that everyone wears, and plaid, you know. Although I have to confess that as youth, my one of my favorite colors was plaid. But I got over it. So, you know, basically, I feel very out of place. I feel like an idiot is what I do. You know, I'm out of place here, and I'm very depressed about it. So, I'm just going to leave you, but first, I have to introduce the next number. This was required. Miss Mara Hedges will sing "You Ought to Be Here With Me." A big round.
Where you are. Yes.
How's it look? Pretty good? Thanks. We have a special guest in the audience with us tonight. A scout from down south has come graciously to see some of the talent we have here in the New York City Church. I'd like y'all to welcome, sitting right up here, Mr. Harold Bubba Watson. Bubba, thank you for coming. This is Keith, Bubba Watson's brother. Visiting from Alabama. Mr. and Mrs. Watson had a sense of humor. They named all their children Bubba. They've got a lot of children. I just want you to know that Harold was a Boy Scout, and he's from Alabama. That's the kind of scout he was. And I'm not sure if he's got any talent. Should we bring him up? No. We have another special guest. She is an institution here at the Opry. And I'm just honored to be on the same stage with her. And she's just a legend in her own time. I'd like you all to greet and meet Miss Minnie Pearl.
Chocolate pie, his mama was in the kitchen cooking chicken out.
would call it a legend. Yeah. This next song, I kind of identify with because I am from the streets of Brooklyn. Grew up hard, rode hard out in Brooklyn. And I saw a lot of these guys. You see them in the streets of New York a lot. The name of the song is Desperado. So all you people from down south, Kimberly Ashley's, sing Desperado.
Where do they go when the night of these stars?
time here. Well, for our next number, I know you guys want some more songs. You want some more songs? I want something to drink. Can someone get me something to drink? We have the McKintoshes. I know you've waited for a long time to hear this. The McKintoshes, Miss Debbie. And Enoch Sherwin. Singing a lovely way. Let's hear it. Come on.
I found with you through the years. I've never you before. I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. The years, through all the good and bad, I knew how much we had. I've always been so glad to be with you. By loving you, through the years, when everything went wrong, together we were strong. I knew that I belonged right here with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid.
Thank you.
great to be a Christian. Amen?
Amen.
Our next performer is someone you know pretty well. You saw her in Upside Down. She tore your heart out as Abigail, Peter's wife. She's going to come up and do that again. Very shortly. Yeah. This is It's our first Sunday at the Beacon, and the address is 74th Street and Broadway. Please come, bring your friends, bring your family, bring people who aren't your friends, who aren't your family. Now this last song that we're going to be doing is one that's familiar to you. It's a song that is especially close to my heart. Plus of my background. This is Keith Bubba Watson singing God Loves the Gentiles.